Hello there! Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. You're watching Pro Model Scapes. My name is Shlok Karthik. As you know, in the last video, we kind of reviewed this. I wouldn't exactly call it a review, but yeah. I will do a more in-depth review of this in another video. But today, I'm really excited because... You can't even see my face. But we're not going to be unboxing this big thing because it's not mine. Instead, we're going to be unboxing the new Tamiya soldier kit. Let me just pop this back in and... So I'm really excited. Mom ordered this and... Let me just get this box open and I'll get back to you later. One. So guys, here's the set. It looks awesome. It looks amazing. It comes with about 8 figures and I have to paint all of them. But that won't be done in this video. Let me just clear up my table, and by that, you know what I mean. Throw it off the table. So, let's start doing the review. So, I'll just give you a better angle and let's... So guys, as you can see, this is the kit. You have got some pretty good covers over here. And this is the military miniatures 1-35 scale German Panzer Grenadiers set. So you can actually add these into the tank, but it's not necessary. You can have them as a private collection, like I am going to be having. We have a set of decals on the side. And on the other side, we have the list of all the extra equipment we get, which is not that much actually. But we have 3 extra guns and 1 water carrier. So let me just open this and show you the inside. So guys, now that I got the set opened up, let me just show it to you. So again, the first part of the set was the box, and this is the back. As you can see, they've given us a description of everything. So basically, we have one standing, one sitting, one who's completely prone, one who's firing, right? Then we got one who's ready to move. And then, again, this set is, you can also make it separately, but you can also build it with a tank. But they do not include the tank in this set. So you can separately buy the tank completely painted and add these on. So the tank which is suited to these guys is the Panzer Kopfwagen 4. So if you're going to use these, the Grenadiers, they're going to be used with that. So then we have the all the extras that come with this. We have the other thing, reviewing this kit. And then we have this. As you can see, it's incredibly detailed. We have the standard issue German helmets right there, if you can't see them. And then we have the Mauser rifles, extremely detailed. These rifles right here, the Mauser rifles. And then we have the MP50 standard machine gun, German issue. Right, and then, let's see, we have water canteens and the trench shovels. And then we have a pack of cigarettes and, let's see, and we have binoculars. As you can see, this set is extremely detailed. The white little page over there, they're the decals. So in another video, I will be painting one of these to show you how to paint them. If you buy these, I would highly recommend them. Again, these brands don't sponsor me. So I hope you all like this review, and let me just go over the parts again. So you have all the main pieces with the decals inside. This comes with about 8 soldiers, just to be exact. And you get a lot of extras with this, but then again, with the tank, you can also buy some, you can buy brick walls and add-ons to add in with these if you're going to use them in a separate diorama. So we have that, we have this, and we have the things concerning this kit. So, but one thing I'd recommend if you're building a kit like this, which is extremely detailed, I would recommend, let me just get into that when I show you my face. So guys, when you're using a detailed kit like this, I would recommend being extremely careful because these are extremely fragile. Like while I was opening this one, hand just fell out. Don't worry, nothing to be worried about. It's just dangling over there, that little piece. So when using these, you're going to get something known as mold lines. Now, mold lines are very irritating when you're working on skin and clothes. In clothes, if you miss it, it's fine. They look like wrinkles. But on skin, mold lines are basically the residue. So when you're basically molding these out, two things are pressed together which have a shape in them after the mold is poured in. So some of it, the excess come out which cause mold lines. Now you can easily get rid of mold lines by using an X-Acto knife like I have here, my hobby knives. Again, you don't need an exact same hobby knife I have, you can choose any. But that's what I'd inform if you're using a small kit like this. And again, it comes with a lot of decals. To be using decals, you have to be very careful. I'm going to be making a video on how to use and remove decals, because when I was using decals, it was really frustrating for me to get them all. A lot of them got ruined, which also kind of, you know. So that was it for this review. This is a very short video, I think. So again, it comes with three guns. We have a pistol on the side and binoculars, and we have knives. I do not exactly know what to call these, but you also have the standard grenades, the machine grenades, right? And then you have the standard issue helmets. So this set doesn't come with any commanders though. I'm just gonna let you know that. It's just all the soldiers, no commanders, and no lieutenants. So I'm almost done, guys. Let me just show you one last thing. So guys, I hope you all enjoyed this video. Again, I told you everything about this kit. I actually put everything back in because I do not want to harm any pieces. But if you're going to be building a kit like this, I recommend building some kits before this, like many big kits. I have built two kits before this. I have the Messerschmitt, the German Messerschmitt BF-109. And I have built the Leichter Panzer Sportwagen 222, which is a German scout car. If you're going to build a very small detailed model and you have no experience, even I have no experience, I'm a starter in this, but I think I know the basics by now. So I would recommend getting to watch a lot of videos, because I watched like 5-6 hours of videos before starting my first ever model and how to use airbrushes and stuff. Now, I hope you all enjoy this video, and I will see you on the next one.